much for tonight. We know in the Bible days, leaders and heroes celebrated their birthday, and people's heads were cut. Others were executed. But Lord, to your name be the glory that tonight your daughter is celebrating her birthday, that in your presence there's going to be a blessing unto all those who participate. In your presence, he's going to find favor from you, that you increase her days and years. In your presence, you are going to bless this family. Amen. And you're going to affect everyone who is here. Amen. Father, we thank you for that your presence is going to be a blessing to everyone who is here. Amen. We invite you to take control from the beginning to the end. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Reverend Alice Jambere. I will just take this opportunity to tell you the importance of prayer. So we have been one month prayer. The AC, Metro. And I did miss you soon, Metro. I don't know whether we have some people who don't actually understand our language. If we do, please let me see your hand. Oh, okay. Be all by now, watch your chin. We brought phone and come up. There were three ladies in Ghana. They were selling things in Kaswa. One was selling bread. One was apple. And one was also selling apple. And then the other one was selling yam. The importance of prayer. Now, I could not talk pound on them, but the whole thing of Christ is a Bible move. So, pump by a beer and go pump it in. And your man and his son was the Lord. You will say that you are the bread of life. Okay, you pay, ho, not the pound in your uncle, folk, you want to pound in your nasa. They will talk about the whole thing of your son, okay. Lord, you said you are the apple of my eye. Also can prepare. Oh, now pulling in eye, pulling in eye. I come, sister, not to yam. Yam, the only Bible. So how is he going to sell her yams? Also, you know, what he said, Lord, you said, I yam that I yam. I yam that I yam. If you are going to troubles, if you are going to tribulations, please remember to pray. Amen.
Amen.
Right now we have a special guest in our midst, a special person in our midst, who is going to share the affairs of today. I can't share, man. No, be full say, be 10,000. No, we are all chair people. Chairpeople, chairpersons, and chairman, and chairwomen, and chairladies. But we want our leader. Your inherent leader. And here, Nipa, Obeshe, Nedjumedin in our Kosu, the one who is going to sit to represent all of us here. I think that, is he here? He's not here. So the moment he comes in, I'm going to introduce the chairman or the chairperson for tonight. For now, call yourself a chairperson. Tell yourself, I'm a chairperson. Yeah, I'm a chairperson. Not on so my end, yeah, a chairperson. Or by you two, but on my end here, now, yeah, chairperson. Why are we here tonight? The Lord has blessed one of our sisters, one of our mothers, one of our friends with Paul, 40 years. Now, when you go to the hospitals now, and you find some people just struggling to live for a day, listen, that you be bringing something for hours. You find out that it's not easy for you to get it. If the Lord has blessed you for you to live up to today, then just say hallelujah to God. Just say hallelujah to God. You are blessed. Say I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
When you go to Kolebu and you go to the cemeteries, people like you, 34, 32, this time, they don't even go to their 60s. 23, 25. I went to Ghana and I was just going through it. I visited the cemetery and I said, let me look at specific people that I know. 23, 21, 22. Sometimes you'll find out that 30 is plenty. Are you special than them? You are not. Meaning that God has really blessed you. Say, I'm blessed again.
I'm blessed.
If you believe it, say, I'm blessed again.
I'm blessed.
We are not here for hearsay. We are not here just to party. But we are here to recognize that there is a God who is taking care of us. There is a God who has made us live the way we are living now. There is a God who has made you think like you have a hope tomorrow. Our sister Nana has a hope tomorrow. Let's say amen to that.
Amen.
If so, yeah, Nana, one sir. We are going to invite the celebrant. And most of the time, when I was talking to them on the phone, Reverend was always trying to see a situation where I can neglect him so that he wouldn't dance. But no, I wasn't able to do that. So we are going to invite Reverend and Mrs. Eshen on the floor for the first dance. Please, let's give them, the space is too small. Let's give them, you know, enough time for them to shake themselves. And after that, I will invite friends and loved ones to join them. Mr. DJ, give them a powerful song, a beautiful one, and one that can go with it. Reverend and Mrs. Eshen, let's see them on the floor. Give them a big applause.
Thank you.
And anytime I go a place like this and I see him, we coordinate very well. And we are doing some coordinations, and I know the song that he's going to play tonight, you are going to enjoy it. What he hates is that when he plays songs and you don't dance, then you start to complain. Please, I don't want him to complain today. So once you hear him play a song, please, dance. Right now, we know we are going to do something. We are just going to wave our hands. You may hear me and say, I can say, happy birthday, old girl, old 40 years. Happy birthday. Himusa, Himusa. Himusa. Ah, 40 years. Him, you know here? Him. Ah, good. Teacher, you can not see. Obey, use him. Now, I'll transform a sentence. John Kojo Mensa. A man is a son of teacher the friend. As yes, Kojo, as in him is life. Clap for him. And Paul Ankuma, also man is also. As yes, Paul, as I love him. Clap for him. Yeah. Akojo Minko. Also man is also. Oh, teacher. Me him means that. Clap for him. We need a word of exaltation at this time. And times like this, you know, we have to take something home. I'm so glad that on the program we have somebody who has prepared to give us something precious in relation to the occasion that we are celebrating. When I saw this, I said, this is the first time I've seen it, that we are going to have a word of exaltation. I know it's going to be very short, like a lady's skirt, but it's going to be powerful. Amen.
Amen.
You know, a lady's skirt, even if it's short, it covers all the part of the body. Ladies and gentlemen, If Reverend Cecilia Larry is here, then we are inviting her to take the microphone to give us the word of exaltation for tonight.
In life, we have three special occasions. The first one is when you are born. The second is when you get married. And the third is when you depart this world. And in all, there is always a celebration. A birthday party, we are all children of God. And the way I see it, it's like we are seeds of God. God plants us And even the farmers, when they plant their crops, every year they do harvest. And this is our harvest time. Each year, on your birthday, always remember that it's the time of harvest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because when you are dead, you can't produce. So keep this as a special day. And we thank God so much. Psalm 118, verse 23 and 24. It said, this is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our hearts. This is the day the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Look at how beautiful it is to celebrate a day such like this. Not unto us, but unto the Lord be the glory.
Yes.
We give all the glory to God. When God plants you in a desert, for sure, you will be fruitful. Because it is the Lord's doing. When we see each other, we smile, we look beautiful. It is the Lord's doing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I just want to sing. Wanana wa ye yensa. Enana wa ye yense ye. Eyo nya mene Jesus. O nya mene do. No. Mipa mucho musori na ma. Yes, why are saying, oh Jesus? Are you not? No, Jesus, we just want to thank you. We lift you up, we give you all the glory because you deserve it. We thank you so much that we are blessed and we continue to be blessed because you, Lord, you have planted us. Glory be your name. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
God bless you, Reverend Cecilia Larry. That's one unique thing about this occasion, and I will never ever go without mentioning it. We have men of God in our midst. When I say men of God, I don't mean that you are not a man of God, but we have men of God who are playing the role that they're supposed to be playing. They are like professionals. Amen.
Amen.
Because, you know, Reverend, he's a professional. So all his compatriots are here with him. Probably wouldn't be able to mention all names, but there was one man that when I see, he inspires me a lot. When I came to this country, he was the first man I saw. And the reason he told me was that if you are in this country and you are without God, you are nothing. And it has always rang in my ears. Anytime I see him, I remember that word. Amen.
Amen.
If Elder McKeon is here, please, let's give him a big applause. Elder and Mrs., if you are here, give them a big applause. Ah, yeah. Ma'am, you're welcome.
Amen.
We also have Reverend Benny Reverend Bennett is also here. Oh, she's the one who gave us the opening prayer. Bonsam Kesema Nyami. Yeah. Some of us are porters. Somebody else. Amen. It now is you. Because I'm not sure. Now what you say, what soon then you make you start making noise. No. Let's give him a big applause. Yeah. Computer. Evangelist Bobby Takisu Hap, I'm sure Mommy and Fine some book as a piano. Good. Evangelist, you are welcome. Reverend Nana Ata Bukua. Oh, mommy. Atu, I'm going to tell you what. I'm here to show.
Amen.
My young Reverend Tisia Lati. Oh, sorry, Labi. Oh, no, the one who just gave us the exaltation. Larry, yeah. I mean, the one that I saw here was like a different one. Reverend Cecilia Larry. Mumia Bonsam Kesimana. We also have some brethren who actually travel far and away from here and would like to recognize them. If you are in New Jersey and you just drove from Paterson to this place, why are you in Nobio of New York and not Pennsylvania? And Waswaba. Mr. and Mrs. Ampoma from New York, if they are here, please, let's welcome them. Good, good, good. And then we have Miss Elizabeth Manti. From Ohio, Nyagro. Yeah. Oh, yeah. When we were kids, when we were like in secondary school, Ohio, we say Ohio. That's what we say. Not that we came here, we didn't know that it's Ohio. We say Ohio. Elder and Mrs. Ishmael from Pennsylvania. Ah, Ishmael, a good friend. We also have Mr. Mark Safer, also from Ohio. Mr. Mark. Yeah. Mr. Mark Safer. We have Elder and Mrs. Kumi. Are they also here? Oh, good, good. French to me. And then when you go to one of the elders that I also know very much, Elder Ekumi. Power! He's a very strong man of God. What's up, Kesemano? We are seeing these people here because they love our sister, because they love our reverend, and they love the family, and they love what? The family of what? God. Amen. Amen. And so, I'm the master who don't eat. We are not here because of that. We are just here because we love them. Amen. And for that reason, there was a small boy, a small man at the back table there. He's called Mr. Kwame Nyako. I like that name because Kwame Nyako is very powerful. One fan macrobeji. But he is going to be sober today. And what he wants you to do is that whatever you brought for this occasion, for our sister, please just go there, Kude, and write your name and show your appreciation to Mr. Kwame Nyako. And for that reason, tomorrow morning, you hear that we'll be calling you to say a big thank you. So having said that, there was a big man that I did not mention because I wanted everyone to come in so that we all welcome him. He has been a great man for Reverend and Mrs. Ishen. I think that he has been the one who was throwing the light for them to see. Ladies and gentlemen, let's all be on our feet and welcome Reverend Asamoah. Give him a big applause. He has been a big mentor for Reverend and Mrs. Ishen. Patom said, Miss Michelle Swaba, Miss Michelle, Patom, myself, me, my Kaba, Michelle. Michelle is also here. Michelle, if you are here, let's see you by hand so we can also give you a warm welcome. Michelle. Where's Michelle? Oh, Michelle, you are welcome. Give her a big welcome. And we have Miss Evelyn. Evelyn is also here. Evelyn, Edlin, right? Oh, Edlin, let's also see you by hand. If you are closer to him or her, no, I teach a criminal training. Oh, sorry. We thank you for coming. All right. So, when you look on your program, you see that we have a lot of dance. And I think that we are going to do it in a combo. Yeah, we are going to do it in a combo. So, at this time, we are going to welcome the celebrant again on the floor. And I would like her to be joined by all her siblings. So, Mr. DJ, give us a song. This time, it's minus Reverend. Reverend was looking at me and said, I don't want to come again. This time, it's the celebrant and her siblings. The children, the sisters, the brothers, and everybody who is very close, closer to her, you are invited to dance with her. Mr. DJ, give us a big song. Sisters and brothers. Song for the Igbe people. God so good, he has granted traveling mercies to our chairman, and our chairman is here. We've been waiting for our chairman. We have all been chairmen, chair ladies, chairwomen, and now we have voted, elections have come, and we didn't win. So NDC people have won. The election went to court. So whoever was before the chairman or you are chair lady, whatever it is, court begged it. Achukuba said, we are no more. Let's welcome our chairman for the occasion, Mr. Stephen Lancy. Give him a big applause. And then he's going to give us his acceptance speech. Mr. Lancy, we've been waiting for you. Thank God that you are here with us. And then you are blessed to be with us. Here you are.
I know this is not a church. It's a birthday celebration. But I'm going to say, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
I want to thank everybody here for honoring this occasion. Helena is my daughter that I've always cherished. I've known her for years. I saw her when she was a kid. Now she's 40. So I'm gonna thank you all, each one of you, for coming here to grace this occasion. And we know on birthday celebrations, we have to do something. Each one of us is capable of doing their best today. So I'm going to thank everybody in advance for heeding to my plea and accepting to do what's good in the sight of God. Thank you all.
Amen. You know, there are people who are very, very lucky. And then anytime you see them, lucky things come. Things that are good come. You see, the moment the chairman says something, they are bringing the food. Just say food. So we are going to set up the food, but we are going to kill two birds with a stone. If you look on your program, we have some tributes that they are going to give about our sister. So we'll be doing that, and at the same time, they'll be setting up the table for us to eat. Please, all what I would like you to do is that the food is for us. We are going to eat everything from that particular bowl. But for now, I will ask you to just bring your ears here and your attention to whoever is going to say something, so that by the time we finish those things, we eat the food, we have more time to dance, and then we can also be out of here on the time that we have been given. So we're not rushing you out, but we are trying to put things together so that we can enjoy the program in the fullest. At this time, I'm going to invite a man of God, Reverend Asamoa, to say one thing. You know, men of God always have something to say. And I think that once he's here, he has something under his sleeves that he wants to give to us. I love him so much, and I would like also to love him. Reverend Asamoa, this is your time.
Hallelujah. Praise the living God. We serve a powerful God. That we shouldn't sit down like there is no spirit in us. Say hallelujah, somebody. Say, I love Jesus. Amen. 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 It's my pleasure to be here. And as a matter of fact, I never prepared to say anything. But the word of God says in season and out of season that the man of God should continually be filled with the richness of the word of God. I'm not going to preach. But if you are here at this blessed moment, all I want to tell you is that Jesus Christ came into this world. And he came with a message. And his message is, you must be born again. Unfortunately, some people are making church out of Jesus' message. A religious organization out of the message of Jesus Christ. Who came and said, unless we repent, we shall likewise perish. Luke 13:3. So I'm just here as a vessel of blessing to let you know that your church is nothing before God. It is the reception of Jesus Christ into your heart and into your life and experiencing the power of his change in your life. So that when the time comes and they sing Captain of Israel, Host and Guide for you, you will be in the bosom of Abraham. The reason why we are here is because of two wonderful people who have given their lives to the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you are here and you are here for the food, it's good. Because when Lazarus was raised from the dead, Jesus said, give him something to eat. So food is good. But the best food is Jesus Christ, who came as the bread of life. So that when we eat him and he become part of our faculty and members, we will live again. God bless you. Believe Jesus. Love him. Trust him. And let him bring a change in your life. If you are in a church, you have not changed. You are not a Christian. Jesus selected one of his disciples and his name is Peter. I'm going to give you what Peter said about that. He said, you know that you were not redeemed with silver and gold from the old traditions of your fathers, but you were redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ as a lamb without blemish. I encourage you to take this word and believe that with Jesus, things can change in your life. And you can one day inherit eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. I have seen so many people. I have been around for a long time. I look like a small boy, but I'm not a small boy. I am the youngest old man ever lived. And the truth is that you must be born again. The power of sin must be broken in your life. There are so many people in churches, and they are still sinning. God bless you.
Amen. I can't draw. One prepare for you. When we were in school, there was something we call sum proportion. If less, more divide. If more, less divide. Now, so prepare any and prepare more. Man of God, we thank you so much. God bless you too. God bless you too. Now, some corner there, he spoke in American language. And then there was a man who was trying to interpret a preacher's preaching. Now, Achepa, he was just like me until Professor Mala. So this man, the preacher man said, you Christians of these days, apparently so, Mwe Christopher and the Maba, I don't know what is happening to you. Whether you are worshiping God or you are worshiping idols, some Musu Nyame and I say Musu Abosum. I don't know which is which. I don't know which is which. Thank you. This message that came to all of us, we understood it perfectly well. There wasn't a nyembi anye in it. The whole thing that I heard that was powerful was that if you have not been born again, then go to Nicodemus. And then Nico will tell you what it means. We're also going to invite a man of God to say something about our sister. And I'll invite Elder Emmanuel Donko. Emmanuel.
Oh my daddy ban, oh yeah yeah yeah, hallelujah, yamitiasuda. Oh my daddy ban, oh yeah yeah yeah, hallelujah, yamitiasuda. We thank the Lord for another time. The Israelites walked in the wilderness for 40 years. God gave them manna to eat. But after the manna, God said, go to the land I have given you. That land, there is no manna there. You are going to farm the place for yourself, and then the milk and honey, you take advantage of it. Helena, 40 years, God has taken you through the wilderness. But the years ahead, you are going to take the milk and the honey, and God is going to satisfy you all with his love and joy and blessing. God bless you. Amen.
Elder, it has been great. We thank you so much for this powerful song. This song has been a song that is always on the lips of Christians, because if you understand the song very well, you will sing it every day. Every day. The food that we eat, the bread that we have. As many as you can, as this year, what's it? Now, I say, oh, God, oh, electricity. I just told the offense and queens. Who is she? Now, the queens need shema. Queens need sano. Now, what power is here then? Eh, sir. And sometimes you go to buy the coins, 50 Ghana cedi. Obedu funeral reception at 30 Ghana cedi. How would you even know that? And people are suffering in Ghana. Now let's relate this to God. If God is to give us that quench, how many of us will be able to buy more? We've been doing 2 jobs, 3 jobs, and still our bills. So if you get the food to eat every day, if you get the breath to breathe every day, then it's your responsibility to know that there is a source, and you need to give thanks to the source all the time. Amen. Electricity Corporation, for what's in CC, I want to mean, share electricity bill, cut a candle. They have said it point blank. Go and buy a candle or turn off your light. When we turn off our breath, how long are we going to survive? It's God who has been giving us all these things. We are also going to invite another man to come. Oh, sorry, another lady to come and give us another tribute. Let's welcome Miss Lydia Adum and Blessed. Adum and Blessed, when I saw the name, I thought that they were coming from
Ohio. So when I saw them, I saw the name here, I thought that they were coming from Ohio. Not knowing that they are coming from within the family. Some of us, we saw them born. Some of us, we went to their adorings. Some of us, we saw them grow. Now they...
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Wait for them.
Please, let's give them time to wait for the microphone. I want to hear exactly what they are going to say. I'm so impressed. Very, very impressed. Because I saw them. I saw them with my group eyes when they were born. You are going to tell me something, right? All right, Adam, blow your.
Praise the Lord.
Today, let's be very quiet and listen to them.
Today, I am here with my siblings to say something to my mom. Because she has been there for us since we were very little. She brought us forth into this world by the grace of God. And we have grown to this stage today. Mommy, I love you so much. Aww. You are my everything. Even though, yes, we have our disagreements, I love you from the bottom of my heart. God brought you onto this earth through my beautiful grandmother. And now you are here, you are grown, and you have given forth to beautiful children. I love you so much.
We can.
You know what? It is a touchy moment, and I would like us to have the microphone. Please, work on the microphone, and once it comes on, it's very touchy. Please, let's listen to them.
Wait, give me 1 minute.
1 minute. Okay, thank you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Dear Mommy, we love you so much. The Lord brought you through our beautiful grandmother, Ruth, but she's not here with us today. And you have come and you have grown to the stage and you have given birth to 5 beautiful children. We thank you. All we can say is thank you because only the Lord knows how much we love you. And how every day you are there for us. You have taken us back and forth from school, hospital when somebody is sick. But when somebody is hurt, we love you so much.
Aww.
We love you with all our hearts. If it wasn't for the grace of God, we wouldn't be here today. And we just want to say thank you. Just thank you for everything. What shall I say unto the Lord at this moment?
Since the Lord brought me to this country, it's a lot that I have passed through. But when you have God, you have everything. And when you put your trust in Him, He alone can cater for us. Today has been a great day that the Lord has made. Since I was praying with Lady Adon, so many people know what I have been through, especially my Pentecost people, Church of Pentecost. And if I see Adon like this, I give glory to God.
Yes.
For all trials, accidents, so many things happen. But I know the Almighty God that I have put my trust in Him. He has protected me and guided us in a special way. And bringing my wonderful husband, Reverend Kwesi Somisheni. Whom I love so much. Handsome, the handsome one. I love you so much. You are my darling. God richly bless you too for being a wonderful husband.
Wonderful indeed.
What shall I say unto you all for your prayer support, kindness? I give glory to God.
Amen.
My children, Lady Adu Mishen, blessed Kofi Sobe Ishen Jr. Angel Rose, Yabu Kukua Ishen. Anointed Ya Ejapoma Ishen. Bishop Nyamitiasi Kwesi Ishen. The baby of the house and the bishop of the house. I love you all so much. And God richly bless you and keep you under His umbrella. For the loving kindness. Love you all here. My mother, Auntie B, and your Jimmy. God bless you, Mommy. My daddy, Mr. Lindsay. God bless you too. With all the ministers and the elders and the church members. And my sisters, Angel, Linda, Tina, Mrs. Eduse, Mrs. Elizabeth, hey, okay, my number one sister, what shall I say? God richly bless you all. And all of you here, my wonderful brother Ben, Roxanne. I haven't forget about you. I love you, dear brother. God bless you all.
Amen. Bon sang que c'est mon amour. I was going to give a special time to talk, but we'll be on track. And I think it's okay. Amen. This is very natural, right? Very natural. We are not doing artificial stuff here. The food is also natural, I think so. Organic. The food is also organic. And one thing that she said that is going to actually bother me a little bit is that most of the time, our wives, they demand that we have to be saying, I love you every morning. Now that she said that, when I go home, I know tonight I'm going to have a problem. Men here, please, let's be saying that. We love our wives. Say, I love my wife.
I love my wife.
Oh, we want to mean come. But those of us here, we love our wives. God knows that we love our wives. The only problem is that when you get up early in the morning, you are going to work and everything is, you know, stress and all those things, you forget. Sometimes too, by the time you wake up, she's gone. Or you're also gone. Now we have phones, but we go to work and we forget that we have phones. So when it comes to the African mentality and African culture, the word love has become very big for us to be saying it every day. But those of us out there, yet me are not war American, I love you in the Insumo. They say it every day, but there's no substance in it. Amen. We say it once a while, and there's a big substance in it, right? Yeah. The day we say I love you, you know something going to happen.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Sometimes you see that we don't even say it, but our actions will prove that we love you, right? Sometimes we don't even say it. Some of us, we don't even talk when we're on bed. The legs will talk for us. The legs. We move the leg in a way, and you see that we are telling something to you. That you have to mention the name. Amen. Amen. Reverend Eshan has gone through that. And because of the good works, if we're a man, now we're a man, now a problem. Reverend Eshan has something to say to the wife. Let's give him a big applause.
First of all, I want to give thanks to God for the good things He has done in our family, in the life of our family. And then another thanks go to the church members, especially Reverend Bishop Asamoa. Hallelujah. Since I came to America, I have been with him. People are saying a lot of things, but I don't want to go there. Amen. And he is a very good man. He's a very good man. And I thank, in fact, time is gone, else I will say a lot of things. Because when I came to this country, there was a lot of things going on. A lot of problems. It's not easy. We've went through certain things, but God is with us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I always keep quiet and talk to God. God is my friend. He's very close to me. So I call him Charlie. Charlie, what is going on? Amen. I can remember one year, I think 2009 or something. My wife had 3 accidents within the same year. And I asked him, Charlie, what is going on? So there's something going on back, and they need her, maybe the spiritual realms or something. And I said, that would not be possible. That would not be possible. Since my child lives and I live, it will be possible. Amen. So I don't want to say much. I always call her Iron Lady. Because the things she does, I think I cannot do like a quarter of it. In fact, God has created women in a special way. If you have a wife, just take your time and move with her in a special way. You know that God has given you a gift. Hallelujah. They are special. And the things they do, I tell you, if you're a man, you can't do a quarter of it. I'm telling you, it's not easy. Amen. The way these 5 children, and the way we go through certain things, sometimes I feel tired. So my friend, you brought them up, so if you can, you just... It's not easy. It's not easy. And we thank all of you, Mr. and Mrs. Ben Bwampo. Father, when we came to this country, I don't want to go there, but I say God bless them.
Amen.
Amen. And then Elder and Mrs. Edusa. Ebusiapeni, and Ebusiapeni, Ishmael, and Osman. Amen. They are very special people. They are very special people. So I have to mention their name. There was one time I went to church at Calvary Pentecostal Prince, your place where you were, when you were at, is it Roselle? Roselle. I went there. When I came home, there was 2 guys standing at where the garbage was. And when I was entering, he just held my back. He said, give me your wallet. In fact, I heard that you don't have to struggle with them when it comes to that point. So I didn't struggle with them. They just took the wallet away. And when they went, I just ran. There was one guy. He said, help, help. Not knowing that he was with them. So he pulled that short gun, said, "Give your wallet, give your wallet." Then the one with me also pulled a knife. It's a whole lot of things. Immediately I ran to Adeduse. I said, "Elder, I'm gone. They have taken my ministerial license from my pocket. So what do I do?" In fact, we've gone through a lot, but she has been with me. I could remember when she had wanted me to come here, it was another lot of things. He spent a lot of money. Somebody chop all that money. If you have a wife, just hold her very well. Amen. Just cleave to her and pray to God, and God will make your wife a managing director in the house, and you know that indeed marriage is sweet. Amen. When you take it well, it's very nice. Okay, I'm cutting my this thing. God bless all of you, those who have given a gift and things, and I mean going to say Mr. and Mrs. Okai and Elder and Mrs. Alote and Mr. Lindsay and a whole lot of things. A whole lot of them. Amen. I mean, you are so special people. If not so, you will not come here. Amen. So we thank you so much. God bless all of you. In fact, my prayer is that God, as you go to sleep, as you leave this place, God will guide you. God will protect you. God, I mean, will be your special friend. Any plans of the enemy concerning your life today as you have come here, I pray to my God that God will cancel all plans of the enemy from your life. And I pray that every hole that the enemy has dug against you will be closed by angels in the name of Jesus. And I pray that every sword that they rest up against you will not prosper in the name of Jesus. So let it be written, so let it be done. In Jesus' mighty name, I command it to happen. Amen.
Amen. Listen, this event is a buy one get free event. You came here for a party. Now you are getting blessings. I want to get one free. How many events have you gone to have this thing before? No, you go and then we play Ahedo. Then you'll be shaking yourself with sweat. And once you go out there, the police, please, can I have your license? Can you blow that thing? When you blow it, pow. The court that you go, the things that you go through, you see that you have regretted going to a place like that. We have gotten a place. We are at a place that we are buying one, we are getting one free. Isn't that beautiful? How many of us enjoy coming here all day? Tomorrow we are going to come here again. Are you going to come? Yeah, we are going to come. Amen. That means that tomorrow is not going to be in this location. It's going to be in a church. That is why we are going to get a full blessing. Amen. There was a man who wanted to divorce the wife. Every day he thinks of how, because the wife was good, but you know things were not going well. So, but the only thing that was preventing this man from divorcing the wife was that this is the time for food. The food is here. So we are going to eat. Now before we eat, we will ask a man of God to bless the food for us, and I will ask Ella Akumi to bless the food for us before we eat. Let's all be on our feet.
Heavenly Father, we thank you very sincerely for tonight. Thank you for your presence amongst us. Thank you that you started with us. And as we continue and as we eat, Lord, we commit what we are going to partake into your hands. We pray that you sanctify it and bless it, so that the strength and energy that we get out of it will be used to glorify your name. We thank you through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
What's up, Kesemano? We also welcome Mr. and J. Chung family here Mr. and Mrs. J. Chung family, they are also here with us. Wave your hands so we'll give you a warm welcome. You're most welcome. Mr. DJ is going to give us a song, and we are going to start from the high table. They have to go and taste the food first before we eat. If there's anything in it, then we'll see where we can pass. Because they brought us here. So, the high table, with all our dignity place, you get up and then you go and serve yourself. And then from there, we go to the two reserved tables. Let's do it, you know, in order so that we don't get congested here. High table first. And this is a time that you can touch. Amen. Please, you can follow. This table can follow,
I'm gonna look no further.
One, please let me know so we'll give you one. Make sure you have a champagne in your glass. You don't have one? Okay, what we can do, we can share. We share, right? All right, so we are going to be on our feet. Let's be on our feet and propose a toast. Right, what I want you to do is that stretch off your champagne to the celebrant and say virtuous words for her from your heart. Say something good from your heart for her. If you are double.
No more babies.
So we wish our sister long life. We wish her long, long, long life. More blessings. Double, double money. Double, double money. Good health.
Amen.
More what? More children, right? So we wish her well in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hip, 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 hip. Everybody drink. Drink.
Yeah.
because food can do something with earth. And we're energized. And when Mr. DJ gave us the song, Come and See, Mrs. Debbie Bwampong, if she's here, we invite her to give us the song. Give her a big, big applause. Mrs. Debbie Bwampong. Hallelujah, Yamitiasio. Oh, my daddy, man. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah, Yamitiasio. Miss Akusianani, what's my way? But you should mind. Oh, my daddy, man. Oh yeah, 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 hallelujah, na metiasio. What the cake now, ba? Na metiasio. Oh hallelujah. Oh dina do no share so da da. Oh my God. Don't leave the dessert. Dessert is powerful. Oh my daddy man, oh yeah, 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 hallelujah. Why are you? Thank you very much, Mrs. Bwampong. All right, let's invite the celebrant, the family, loved ones to come to the table so we can cut the cake. Please don't rush out. It's very important for you to see this, witness this part of the occasion. And make sure you get a bit of the cake before you leave. Reverend Mrs. Shen, this cake is very powerful. Fully decorated. And the cake is sweet. So, the rest of the years in front of them, they are going to experience sweet cake. DJ. We have a special mom who is going to help them cut the cake. Mommy, I'm not going to watch a cake. In.
We thank all the ministers who come in, we thank all the friends who come in, and we thank all the members of Pentecost to come in tonight, and all the believers, and all the Christians, they are here. We thank you all tonight. As we are going to end, we are not going to end without a cake, so we are going to cut the cake with my beautiful daughter. as I'm standing on front of her. So may God bless all of us tonight. The Lord has made. You must rejoice and be glad in Him. Today is your 40 years. The beginning of your life is today. So as you and your husband and your children and the family go to cut this cake, remember that today is not going to be like tomorrow. Tomorrow
Indeed, it is by His might, His grace, and definitely His will that we see what we have seen here tonight. So we say all praise be to His name. Amen. Our next glance goes to our ministers. When you're part of God's family, you are in a good family. They are here with you to support you. That's the family I want to be in. Thank you all for coming and making this program a success. God bless you. To our chairman, Mr. Lindsay, you have been with Mrs. Ashon for a very long time. She's very grateful for you and your family. God bless you. Mama B, oh, Angie Jimmy, God bless you. You've been with us. We are grateful. She's very grateful. God bless you. We have friends and family that came from very far out of state because of this. When you told us that you're coming, oh boy, we did not know that you make it, and you've made it. Ohio, upstate New York, family and friends from out of state. We don't want to mention names, we are going to leave some out. So you know yourselves, from the bottom of our hearts and Mrs. Ashon and family's heart, they're very grateful. God bless you. Whatever you have lost because of her, may the Lord replenish it for you and folks. You came, you made this special. there are some people, we don't want to mention names, but when this party, we started planning it, we gave specific duties to some people. They did it impeccably. You know yourselves. God bless you all. Amen. You've made this program special. And as you have done unto her, you have done it unto your maker. God bless you all, and have a good night.
God bless you too. What kind of what's impeccable? Go and find a man impeccable. Now, Mr. DJ, give us a song. This is a special request for the kids. A cha-cha song for the kids. Cha-cha, cha-cha song. You know cha-cha? Do you have that one? Cha-cha. Kids, all the children, come and dance. We didn't actually recognize you, which of course wasn't good. Children, come to the floor. All the children, this is for you. How do you call it? Cha-cha?
Cha-cha slide.
Cha-cha slide. Oh, okay. Good. I'm not used to that, but it's for kids. Baby, I'm going to
slide to the right. when you give me like fever. I want you to dance with my mess. You can do me like sin. I feel bad. You like pushing love the best time. You make me sing ooh la la la. You wish you, you wish you down. You make me sing ooh la la la. Oh yeah. Mommy come back, she let go. Let me come to me and bros. And when you ask me, it was me. Cause I'm a dog still in love like this.
Yeah.